Good morning. Good morning. Let me start the service with an apology. I didn't realise the time. I was having so much fun cutting X's in the top of oranges. I'm starting later than we normally do. So thank you for no one running out and grabbing me. And welcome to our Christingle service this morning, where we're going to be celebrating Jesus, the light of the world, and the new life and hope that he brings. If you don't know me, my name's Kevin, and I'm the pastor here, and I'll be leading us through this crazy service. It's going to be very bitty, as with all age services. We're a family, and there's bits which will suit some people and other people, but I hope as it all comes together, you'll meet with the Lord Jesus in this place and will know his blessing this day. Just a couple of practical things. So as we've talked about before, throughout the service, we'll have to open the doors to make sure that we get a bit of ventilation. So please just know where your children are. Children, know where your adults are. Don't let them wander out the doors, okay? So be aware of that. And it's also going to be interactive. I'm going to want you to contribute, to share as community. We want to offer our thoughts on what's going on in the service. And so I'll come around, unless there's a volunteer who's going to run with a microphone for me. And we'll have you chatting. If you come up on the platform, though, just be mindful that you'll be on the camera and you'll therefore be on YouTube later on when we put this up. So hopefully, as you came in the door, you were able to collect a bag with your Christingle stuff in it. If you didn't, there's going to be time for you to go back and get what you need. Don't worry, I'll talk you through what you need, when you need it, as we go. And hopefully, by the end of the service, we'll all have built our own Christingle to take away. And so as we gather from our scattered places online and gather in this place today, let's just pause. Let's just be still for a moment, and I'm going to offer a prayer. Thank you, Father God, that we can gather in this place this morning. Thank you for Christmas, which is so exciting. But thank you also for this season of Advent, which helps us to slow down and to remember the true meaning of Christmas, that you, Jesus, are the light of the world, that you are our hope. Please bless us today and help us in all we do. In Jesus' name, amen. So let's stand, if you're able, and sing our opening song of worship. Please, if you can, wear a mask as we sing. That would be really great as we gather together to sing Light of the World. Here I am to worship.
Light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see. Beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. So here I am. I'll never know how much it costs.
you're my God. You're altogether lovely, altogether worthy, altogether wonderful to me.
Amen. Do sit down, and we'd like to read, or Molly's going to read for us, and it's going to be on the screen, our Bible verse, which we're basing our service on.
Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11 says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not harm you, plans to give you hope and a future."
So for some of us, that's a really familiar verse. But because the service is completely based on this, we're going to come back to it a few times during the service. And we're going to read it all together, if you're able, right now, so that we get it into our minds. So Jeremiah 29, verse 11 says,
"For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future."
Brilliant. Thank you, Molly. That's great. Barnaby, you're happy. Mum, are you happy for him to wander around with a microphone for me? Yeah? I trust him. I trust him, Barnaby. So your job is to bring the microphone. You're going to hold it for people near them. Okay? And what question we want to know is, what are you hoping for Christmas? Oh, what are you hoping for Christmas? So we got one right at the back there. If you head through, so up this way, down the middle, Barnaby, down the middle, and then down and along. Keep going, next row, and along there towards Rebecca. Aria, are you not joining in now? You got, yeah. Let's see if we can hear this one. Hold it close to her mouth.
A Santa hat.
Oh, fantastic. What else? It doesn't need to be just children. What are we hoping for Christmas? Okay, one in the middle here. See, watch with hands. There we go.
Sorry. Just to be with our family, because last year we didn't see them at all. So that's really lovely. That's the best present.
Absolutely, to be with family. We've got one right in the back. Barnaby, you're going to go right to the 2 metre zone. Okay, so just go through the doors, follow through. That's it, send him on a wander. That's great. Go and see Dave, what have we got? What are we hoping for Christmas? If you're on Zoom, you can post a comment if you want to, and I'll try and pick that one up as well.
Walnut whips.
A walnut whip?
No, just no, plural. Walnut whips.
Whips. I thought you wouldn't just want one.
Just
I mean,
one.
That's not no help at all, is it?
One's no good.
Yeah, perfect. That's great. Okay, let's have two more. Two more. We got down the front, we've got three. Let's go with that then. Oh, don't worry, Elijah. We'll come back to you. William?
Having Paw Patrol.
More Paw Patrol? Yeah. Yeah, it's good for the environment. Go on.
I want a diary with a code, which we saw yesterday at the shops.
A diary with a code lock. What's she writing in that, eh? That's worrying for the parents. Just over. Barnaby? Just through there. Layla? Layla, just round. Oh, there we go.
I want a Hollywood mirror.
I missed that one. Go again.
I want a Hollywood mirror.
A Hollywood mirror? What's different about a Hollywood mirror? Oh, the lights are on the outside. That's it. Let's go to Elijah. My counting's rubbish, so let's go to Elijah and Dorothy, and we'll stop after that. Otherwise, we'll be here forever. This is good. I'm liking it. So, Elijah.
A remote control robot.
A remote control robot. That sounds exciting. And right up by the door, Dorothy, last one. Change the direction. It's going round. I'll just check on Zoom if there's anyone sharing anything here. No, they're just enjoying their fireplaces on this morning. That's
To be with my daughter at Christmas.
F- Fantastic. To be with family, to be with your daughter. That's great. Barnaby, thank you very much. Do you want to bring that mic back? And I'll use you again later. That was a super job. Thank you. Christmas is very exciting, and it's great to hope for stuff, isn't it? To have an aim for something that is coming. But sometimes it can be really disappointing when we don't get what we want. And in fact, you may not believe it, but actually some of the people who are giving it to you can also be really disappointed when they don't get to give you what you hope for. And that can make us sad. A long time ago, one of the hopes God's people had was that God would send someone who was called a Messiah to rescue them. And over the centuries, God sent messengers time and time again to keep that hope alive. And the promise that with the right time, this Messiah would come and would fulfill his promise. Keep that hope in mind as Layla and Kira come up to read our Advent candle and to light our Advent candle. You doing the lighting? You doing the reading?
Waiting is hard in our fast-paced world. We want the red light to change to green quickly, the shopping queue to move faster, and the Christmas morning to arrive sooner. We forget that before good things happen, we must prepare. Last week, we lit our first Advent candle and remembered those who hundreds of years ago before spoke the promise of the coming Christ child. Today, we also light our second candle. As we do, we remember that throughout eternity, God was preparing us for that very day when Jesus arrived in Bethlehem, and that we are called to keep getting ready as we await the return of our Lord Jesus. In Matthew 3, John the Baptist reminds us of our need to be prepared. To John said, change your hearts and lives because the kingdom of heaven is near. John the Baptist is the one Isaiah the prophet was talking about when he said, this is a voice of one who calls out in the desert, prepare the way for the Lord, make the road straight for him. Many people came from Jerusalem and Judea and all the area around or the Jordan River to hear John. They confessed their sins and baptized them in the Jordan River. John said, I baptize you with water to show that your hearts and lives have changed, but there is one coming after me who is greater than I am, whose sandals I am not good enough to carry. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire.
Let us say together the words on the screen.
Two candles burning bright, chasing away the darkness to light. Two candles glowing light, the blessing of God giving new sight.
Let us pray. Dear God, in this very busy season, with so many things to do, help us to hear your voice calling to make room and be ready for our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Help us to hear your call and turn and follow you. Fill us with your Holy Spirit so our lives will produce good fruit to the praise and honour of your name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you both. And let's stand and sing together an Advent hymn, O Come, Emmanuel.
O come, O come, Emmanuel, and ransom captive Israel, that in lowly exile here.
shadows would divide. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou King of David, come, and of the world of heaven,
and do sit down. And another opportunity for you to share, because we know that Jesus didn't just come at Christmas and then he died and then that was it. We know that he is alive and he is with us in all that we're doing. And so it's an opportunity for us to say thank you. And I'm wondering, what do you want to say thank you for today? It can be absolutely anything. Or maybe there's something where you think, oh, Jesus has really helped me. He's given me hope this week. What do you want to say thank you to Jesus for this week? Do wave your hand in the air, and we'll get Barnaby on the go again if he's happy to. That's great. Barnaby, you're heading straight down to the back by the door. Go through the middle. Okay. That's it, straight round. Good job.
Thank you, Lord, for looking after my son during his accident, and that I'm going to go and see him for Christmas.
Fantastic. Thank you for looking after your son, and you're going to get to see him at Christmas. Absolutely. That's brilliant. On the road to recovery. We keep praying for that. Vicky.
I'd like to thank God for a wonderful Sunday last week when we spread my husband's ashes, and what I was dreading to be an awful occasion turned out to be a lovely afternoon.
Absolutely. Thank you. It's okay. Dorothy at the back.
I'd like to thank God for what he's done for me this year.
Amen. Thank you. Molly down the front.
Okay.
Anybody else?
Thank you for getting our new decorations for the tree.
New decorations for the tree. Yes, William.
And thank you for getting the Christmas tree.
Thank you for getting the Christmas tree. Okay, over there for Sarah. A couple more. That's great. We'll come back round to Dorothy.
Getting 10,000 steps in
today. Two things. Thank you for keeping my work colleagues safe while their children have had COVID. And second of all, thank you for our young people at this church who are willing to get involved and stand up and believe in their faith.
Thank you, absolutely. And Barnaby behind you, Dorothy? Just here? That's it.
Thank you for the time of fellowship that we had on Friday night at the Advent meal. It was a wonderful start to Advent.
Absolutely. Brilliant. We'll leave it there for now, and we'll come back. There'll be another opportunity to share in a bit. So let's do that. Let's say thank you in prayer, shall we? Gracious God, we thank you for this opportunity to gather together, and we thank you for the way that you are active in our lives right now. We thank you for the way that you are encouraging us in the things that we do, whether that's taking part in an event or whether that's in our workplaces. Lord, thank you for your hand of safety upon us. Thank you for the exciting things that we get to do, like getting decorations and Christmas trees. Lord, thank you for the healing that you're working in people's lives. And Lord, we just want to thank you once again for this opportunity to celebrate you as the light of the world. Amen. Amen. Well, we're going to come to our first bit of making our Christingle. But before we do that, we're going to sing a song And this is aimed at those who are younger at heart, or indeed who are young. And this song is going to remind us that in the beginning, God created. And it's really simple. We're going to follow the words with actions. And to help us, I'll just talk us through what we're going to do. William, do you want to help me, or are you not in the mood for helping me? Do you want to help me with these actions? Come on then, come on up. Okay. So, do you remember what we do? We go, what a great creator, what a great creator you are. That's it. And then we do it again. What a great creator, what a great creator you are. Perfect. And then we go through and we say things like this. So, next slide. He made the mountains tall. He made the waterfalls. He made the rivers that flow. He made the sun's bright glow. Next one. He made the tiny ant. We're nicking off the ant on my arm stuff. Yeah. Those who know will know. He made the elephant. You've got to do the elephant trunk. Okay. Do you think he had a laugh when he made the huge giraffe? Give us a giraffe, everyone. A big giraffe in the air, as high as you can. Okay, and then the second verse follows bits of the body, talks about your chin, talks about your runny nose, which, of course, none of us have in this place. Okay, and so we'll do that. So if you're able, do stand with me, and I'll try and lead us, and we'll sing this through together.
What a great creator, what a great creator you are. What a great creator, what a great creator you are. What a great creator, what a great creator you are. What a great creator, what a great creator you are. He made the mountain fall, he made the water fall, he made the river that flows, he made the sun's bright glow, he made the tiny ant, he made the elephant. Do you think he had a laugh when he made the huge creator, what a great creator you are. What a great creator, what a great creator you are. What a great creator, what a great creator you are. What a great creator, what a great creator you are. He made my pointy chin, he made my funny grin, he made my runny nose, he made my fingers and toes, he made my gnashing teeth, he made my dancing feet. Yes, very carefully he created you and me. What a great creator, what a great creator you are. What a great creator, what a great creator you are. What a great creator, what a great creator you are. What a great creator, what a great creator you are.
Fantastic, give yourselves a clap, that's really good. Well done. William, do you want to go and sit down? And we're just going to open up the doors at this point and let a bit of fresh air in. And then we'll carry on with our Christingle. Okay, so today we're going to be making one of these. You can see it on the screen as well. And they're a bit strange, aren't they, these Christingles? But what they do is they help us remember who God is and what he's done for us, especially at Christmas. Now, hold on. We're not going to get the bits just yet because I'm going to talk us through it. But I realize that this is quite small. And so I put mine in my supersizer at home. Okay? Who else has got a supersizer at home? Anyone? No. Oh, wow. I'm exclusive in this place. That's great. Well, my supersizer made my bag all nice and big. Gave me extra paper as well. Okay? And what we got is one of these. Look at that. It did. It supersized it. I won't eat it, obviously. That's not what we're doing here today. Now, this is, of course, an... Oh, good. I'm glad you know. Should try that again. This is a orange. That's great. And the orange represents... The orange represents the world which God created. That's why we sang that song, because he is a creator God. He's made absolutely everything. The animals, the mountains, the rivers, you and me, everything. And God also designed... Now, let me just get hold of this. I brought an extra bit along with me because... there we go. Didn't want it rolling off the table and I'll be running around all the time. Okay, it made something else as well. He made the four seasons and he made all the good things that we have. And we're going to make four sticks, which are going to look like these. Look at that, supersized. That's great. So you're going to find some sticks in your bags like these ones. You're going to find a bag like this. And you're going to find, some goodies like this, which, of course, you're not going to eat. It's not going to happen. All right? And so what you're going to do is you're going to take your stick, and let me show you. Through the spiky end, you're going to put a marshmallow. You're going to put a raisin. You're going to put another marshmallow. You'll get to do this in a second. You'll shove another one. And then, really importantly, cover the spike with your marshmallow. Otherwise, it's all going to go horribly wrong. Okay? And then you're going to get hurt. What we're then going to do is take our orange and we're going to place our spikes into four sides of our orange to represent the four seasons, which is autumn, summer, thank you. What else we got, Edward? Autumn, summer, spring, and winter. There we go. And it's going to look like that. Obviously smaller. So do dive into your bags, and if at all possible, try not to eat everything that's in there as you pull together your first part of your Christingle. Off you go. If you're at home doing this, one of the things you could do is to try and look for something which you think, oh, okay, that really represents to me the good things that God gives me. And so you could make your own Christingle which represents, rather than actually having an orange. Maybe there's something which for you is about the world and everything in the world. It might be a picture of a beautiful waterfall or something like that. So at home, if you want to create your own Christingle out of just household items, do go ahead and do that as well. Sorry? You've run out of sweets? You're eating them all? You need some? You're okay. There's more bags in the lobby if you need anything. We've got all sorts of spares. Unless you're just super hungry and eating them all, then of course that's completely different. So just doing this first bit, don't go on into the next section. We're going to cover the next bits later on. So just doing your things, the good things that God has given us from the four seasons around the world. And I've got our world as well. We're putting those sticks in the top. So don't worry about the candle, don't worry about the ribbon and all that stuff just yet. I should probably say there's an X in the top and that should be facing upwards. That'll probably help as well. Well, whilst you're doing that, let me chat a bit, have a listen to what I've got to say. You see, because the world is an amazing place. And in the beginning, God asked us to get the balance right between using its resources and caring for the earth. And each of us, collectively as church and as individuals, have a responsibility to this call of discipleship and to take seriously the voice of our neighbours around the world who are more affected by climate change than perhaps we are at this time. You know, if the last 2 years has taught us anything, it's how joined up we are with everybody else around this world. And Jesus tells us to love our neighbours as ourselves. And if we're to take him seriously, then we need to consider how we reflect God's desire to offer hope and a future to others, not to harm them. And so one way we can do this is by considering our part as being good stewards of this world. And so if you know how the Baptist world works, we have a church meeting, which is, if you're a member of our church, and you can become a member of our church, have a chat to us about that. But the church members have come together and to discern what they think the big picture of what God is asking us to do is. And at a recent meeting, we decided to explore becoming an eco-church. And the first step to that, which we're aiming to do in 2022, is renewing our commitment to being a fair trade church. And so what that means is that we're gonna start thinking about all the things that we do, seen and unseen, and considering whether there are changes that we can make to make us better disciples, or indeed things we can celebrate that we're already doing that show that we are shining the light of Jesus in our community. And so if this is something that you're particularly passionate about, we, myself or Martin, would love to hear from you. We're wanting to put together a group of people who can help us think this through, to think about what does this mean for us as a community and as individuals. And this links to that verse that we looked at earlier. Can anyone remind me where it came from? What was the name of that book? Jeremiah. Okay, if we have this slide up on the screen. Jeremiah 29, verse 11, and let's say this verse again together. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Now at Christmas, we remember that God came down to earth to lay his head in a manger in an orange. In the world, didn't he? He came to the world and he was born as a baby. But when he grew up, Jesus said something similar to what we also heard him, God saying through Jeremiah. And calling himself the Good Shepherd, he said this. He said, we've got a slide for this one. I came to give life and life in all its fullness. I came to give life. And life in all of its fullness. You see, God wants all people to have access to what they need and to have choice and dignity along with that. And so as we make our Christingle, we remember that the orange reminds us that God created the world, good. And the fruit sticks remind us of all the good things that God has given us. That's great. Okay, I think it's time that we play a little game and we're going to have a think about the game Higher and Lower. Okay, it's a really complicated game. Okay, and Let's see if you can do this. I have supersized my pack of cards. Yeah, there it is. It's all supersized. I love this thing. Doesn't work for my cup of tea, though. That's a shame, isn't it? Yeah. Okay. And all you're going to do is, if you think it's higher when I say, you're going to put your hand up. And if you think it's lower, then you're going to put your hand up later after that. Okay. And if you get it right, you're still in the game, and it's an honesty game. And there's a possibility that if you're the last person standing, there's an awful lot of marshmallows that you can have at the end. Uh-huh. Yeah? There's some hope here. Okay. So our first card, okay, is this one. Oh, okay. Now the question is, do you think it's going to go higher or do you think it's going to go lower? Okay. If you think it's going to go higher, put your hand up now. I'm looking on Zoom as well. I can see the two screens which are connected. And if you think it's going to go lower, put your hand up now. Okay, here we go. Oh, it's a number four. Okay, a little more tricky. Those who think it's going to go higher, hand up now. Those who think it's going to go lower. There's a few going for the low. Okay, here we go. And, number five. If you went lower, you're out. Okay, honesty game. It's going to go higher. Put your hand up now. Okay, if it's going to go lower. Oh, risky, nice, I'm liking this. Here we go. Seven, okay. Those who went lower are out. Here we go. If you think it's going to go higher, put your hand up now. This is more tricky with a seven. If you think it's going to go lower, hand up now. People with maths and probability, here we go. Queen, there it is. Okay, so if you went for higher, put your hand up. Just let's see how many people are still in the game. Let's see, oh, there's a few, there's about 10 or so. Great, okay, so out of those 10, is it going to go higher? One at the back, is it going to go lower? Oh, here we go. Three, okay, higher or lower? Higher? Lower? Yeah, no, let him choose. He's got to learn, hasn't he? He's got to learn sometime, George. George wants the marshmallows. Oh, it's a nine. Okay, here we go. Quicker fire. Higher. Lower. It's a lower. Okay. Higher. Lower. No one's going lower. Oh, you're all out and I win the marshmallows. That's fantastic. There was a piece of hope I didn't know was going to happen. I might actually win myself. Fantastic. You know, hope is a really powerful motivator, isn't it? When we think we might win something, actually it's a really positive thing that can make us keep trying and keep going. And God's love is one of those things, isn't it? To come to earth, it motivates us to know that we're going to be with Jesus once again. It keeps us hoping, even in the darkest of times. We're going to take a short interlude and interview some people as we've been doing over the last, well, started last week, to try and help us as a community get to know one another a bit better. And we're going to have Anna and Charlie, and your family come on up. And Chris, would you like to come up as well? And we're just going to do some quick fire questions to get to know the family and to get to know Chris. So, Chris, if you want to come and stand on this side. And you guys, you can take masks off, yeah, once you're up here. That's great. Thanks. That's it. Come across this side. How many marshmallows have we eaten now? Many?
I think it's this one.
This one? You're eating all the marshmallows. Anna, do you want to come across this side? There we go. Okay, so how long, Chris, have you lived in the local area or and be part of Castle Hill?
I moved to Warwick in 2009, and I started coming here in 2010.
Okay, so you've done over a decade.
Over a decade, yeah.
That's good. Commitment, that's what we like. Okay, and same question to you guys.
We came in the summer, so, well, basically 5 months or so.
Yeah, and you lived in Warwick?
In Warwick, yeah, for the last 10 years since we got married.
And where were you going to church before that?
We were going to Solihull, Renewal in Solihull.
Fantastic.
So we're there for a long time. And
so there's some people here you know as well?
Yes, indeed.
Yeah. Okay, you know the Lettner family, yeah, and that's great. Okay, so what's something that you guys are passionate about or enjoy doing?
Well, I think it's having time as family. I think that's the real thing there. It's just making sure that there's a time together, whether it be outside, whether it be doing modelling as Jonathan loves, but it's just really being together as family when we can.
Fantastic. Thank you. And same question to you, Chris.
Well, my passion is cooking and especially baking.
So. Yeah. We like your cakes. Yeah.
So do I, unfortunately. You
that's great. Now, you guys, how old are you?
I'm six.
You're six. And what's the favourite thing that you like doing?
Modelling.
Modelling. Fantastic. Craft stuff. Yeah, no, it's great. Yeah. Are you going to talk to me?
Do you like doing something?
Well, no. This is practice. What my son does as well.
You said playing toys, didn't you?
Playing with toys. I like playing with toys. I don't get to do it too often, but I do try. Yeah, that's why I go and visit the schools, you see. It gives me an excuse. That's great. Okay, so Chris, what does like a normal week look like for you? What are you kind of doing during the week then?
Well, I only have two free days.
Okay. This is called retirement, isn't it? Yeah.
This is retirement, 14 years of retirement. I help my daughter out once a week. On a Thursday, I work in a bakery in Budbrook, cooking cakes for a cafe down the road. Mm-hmm. And on a Friday, I do the seniors' lunches here.
Great, okay, so you're
and
busy.
This week, there's going to be a lot of preparation because it's our Christmas lunch on Friday, which we're so excited about.
Yeah, absolutely.
We've got 30 guests coming.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
And if there's one thing we can be praying for you right now, what would that be?
Oh, just for peace in this season, that people can continue to get together. And I think we saw that on Friday. The fact that people are sitting together, sharing food, eating together, and chatting and friendship. Yeah.
Okay, great. And so for you guys, what occupies your week?
Well, Jonathan's busy at school, Daddy at work. What do we do, Sammy? Forest school, drama tots, swimming, all sorts of things.
So you guys, what's work for Daddy?
Work in the warehouse environment. Logistics work there, basically making sure there's enough stock in to send out to the building trade.
Great, okay, so logistics. Brilliant, and if there's one thing we can be praying for you guys, what would that be at the moment?
I think as family, just patience and wisdom to bring up our children.
Great,
and
okay.
That's it really.
Yeah, well let's pray together then, let's pray for these things. So, Father God, we thank you for community. We thank you for old and young being able to get together and to enjoy each other's company. And we do pray that your peace will continue to rest on each one of us, that there will be opportunities to keep meeting, and that you will sustain Chris through this season in the ways that she serves you. And we thank you for Charlie and Anna and for the boys too, Lord. And we thank you for Jonathan and for Samuel. And we pray your blessing over them, Lord, that they would grow strong as a family, bedded in your word and knowing you, guiding them and giving them all the wisdom that they need for this difficult task of parenting. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Right, do on head on down. And we're gonna move straight to our second part of our Christingle, which focuses more on the Christmas story. You see, the amazing good news about Christmas is God himself came to earth as a baby to show us how much he loves us and to bring us hope of a new life. And that's why you'll find in your bag one of these, a red ribbon, okay? Yours is made out of paper. And in a moment, you're going to have an opportunity. Someone will come around with some eco-friendly sellotape. Yes, I found some eco-friendly. It composts, okay? And you're going to be able to stick this on around your world, which shows God's love for the whole world. So the ribbon reminds us that Jesus chose to die for the world, so that we might be redeemed, and it's a great thing. And then you're going to find in your bag one of these, which is the candle, okay? And we're not going to light them today as a group, but the candle is there because it represents Jesus, light of the world. That's why it's going in the X in the top of your Christingle, that he brings love, joy, peace, and hope. And do be careful, you've got a tissue in there because you're going to get juice on you as you shove them in. You've got to be quite firm with it. So if we've got some a couple of volunteers, adult volunteers perhaps to do, Namdi, would you help us out with this bit? Sellotape monitoring, that would be great. And whilst that's happening, the music group are going to, music group Barry and Karen, are going to teach us a song based around the theme of Emmanuel, God with us, which we'll be singing on the 19th.
So we sing the first verse. Sing the first verse, then we get people to join.
Sing we the song of Emmanuel, this the Christ who was long foretold. Lo, in the shadows of Bethlehem, promise of dawn now our eyes behold. God most high in a manger laid, lift your voices and now join now with the host of heaven.
Do you want to try singing while you're putting your constructions together? So we'll start from the beginning again.
Sing we the song of Emmanuel, this the Christ who was long foretold. Lo, in the shadows of Bethlehem, promise of dawn now our eyes behold. God most high in a manger laid, lift your voices and now proclaim. Great and glorious love has come to us, join then with the host of heaven. Sages before him fall, grace and majesty, what humility, come on bended knee before him. Go spread the news of Emmanuel, joy and peace for the weary heart. Lift up your heads, for your King has come. Sing for the light overcomes the dark. Glory shining for all to see. Hope alive, let the gospel ring. God has made a way. Tell the world his name is Jesus. Glory shining for all to see. Hope alive, let the gospel ring. God has made the way, he will have the praise. Tell the world his name is Jesus.
There we go, sorry. People at home. So I'm just asking whether we've managed to make our Christingles. And What we're going to do is remember the bits that are part of our Christingle. So the orange is the world which God made, absolutely. The fruit sticks are all the good things, absolutely, that God has given us. The red ribbon tells us of Jesus' love, yeah, absolutely. And the candle is Jesus, light of the world. Fantastic, that's not bad. And here's the great thing. When we go from this place, when we take these away with us and we light them, under supervision, of course, then we also take the light of Jesus with us wherever we go. And even when we've eaten it, or we've composted it, or we've done whatever we have done with our Christingle, the light of Jesus continues to shine because it's in you, and it's in you. And wherever you go, you take the love of Jesus with you. So, that's the positive side. But just as we come to an end, we want to be praying also for people who find this season difficult. There's people who aren't very happy, joyful. There are people who aren't very hopeful. And so I'm just going to say some one-line prayers, and I'm just going to ask you to respond each time to say, light of the world, bring your hope today. So let's start our prayer. It's okay. So let's start our prayer by saying that together. Light of the world, bring your hope today. Jesus, we pray for all those around the world facing the challenge of war. Light of the world, bring your hope today. Lord, we pray for all of those who are homeless at this time. Light of the world,
bring your hope today.
Lord, we pray for those who are struggling because their loved ones are no longer with them. Light
of the world,
bring your hope today. Lord, we pray for those who don't have enough money to survive at this time. Light of the world, bring your hope today. Lord, we pray for those who don't feel hopeful in this season. Light of the world, bring your hope today. Let's say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. And forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Sorry, I swapped two versions in together there. Didn't help you. My apologies. The Lord knows, and that's the key thing. Okay, we're going to come to the end in a moment. Let me remind you of some things coming up. So next Sunday, we have a week early, our communion service. So if you're at home, please make sure you got your elements together for that. And the children's groups will be happening as normal next Sunday. And then in the evening, we have a space to remember for those who want to come together to share lighting of a candle, sharing a memory, whatever it is that is helpful to you in this season, knowing that your loved ones are not with you. It may be that you actually know people who you could invite to that as well, who you know would really appreciate that. So that's 6:30 next week. The following week, on the 19th, we have our pop-up nativity in the morning. And so if you want to come dressed up in costume, you are very welcome. If you've not experienced this before, it's a no-rehearsal nativity. And we just do it with whatever turns up, and we make it happen. And we retell the Christmas story with carol singing. Who's Carol? Come on, someone's got to get in there. And then in the evening, we've got the Wonder of Christmas, which is going to be a lot more organized than the morning service. It's got different drama in it. It's got songs as well as carols. It's got times of prayer, and it's got lots of reflection. And again, it retells the Christmas story. And I know a lot of you have signed up for that already. So that's great. That's about us getting the refreshments right. So please do sign up so we get the right number of mince pies or whatever it is. And then on the 25th at 10:30 in the morning, Christmas Day, I know it's coming soon, okay, we have a service of worship here to give thanks for Jesus on that morning. And do bring a present. Do bring a present with you, assuming that you've unwrapped them by that point. And finally, I just want to put a plug in that a lot of the stuff that we've been using today has been provided by the Children's Society. So they do a lot of the materials. Now, we work with Coton End School as well, and they raise some money and give it to Children's Society as well. If we've already given a donation as part of saying, can we have some of your materials? But if you feel that you've got a spare pound in your pocket that you want to put in the basket on the way out, then that will offset the cost of the donation that we've done. It will become part of all of us doing that. So if you feel you want to, you're very welcome, but don't feel you have to. And finally, I want to remember that at this season, we're on an adventure to Christmas. And so this Christingle is going in my bag because it's the light of Jesus. And it's the light of Jesus that I want to carry with me wherever I go and in whatever I do. Not just so that I can be the light of Jesus, but that he can be his light in me. He can help me learn and to grow in his likeness. And so we're taking that on our adventure into next week when we get to meet together. And our final song explains this one because we talk about, I am a city on a hill. I am a light in the darkness. Jesus living in me can change the world. And so we want to let our light shine. And if God is for us, who can stand against us? Amen. So we let our light shine. If you can put your masks on and let's sing this together, and then we'll bless each other by reading our Bible verse once more.
I am a city on a hill. I am a light in the darkness. Jesus living in me can change the world. I am a city on a hill. I am a light in the darkness. Jesus living in me can change the world. Let my light shine, let my light shine, let my light shine.
Let it shine.
Let my light shine, let my light shine, let my light shine. If God is for me, who can stand against me? Let my light shine, let my light shine, let my light shine. If God is for me, who can stand against me? Let my light shine, let my light shine, let my light shine. We are a city on a hill. We are a light in the darkness. Jesus living in us can change the world. We are a city on a hill. We are a light in the darkness. Jesus living in us can change the world. Let the light shine, let your light shine, let your light shine.
Let it shine.
Let your light shine, let your light shine, let your light shine. If God is for us, who can stand against us? Let your light shine, let your light shine, let your light shine. If God is for us, who can stand against us? Let your light shine, let your light shine, let your light shine.
And so we say over one another, having the slide up, there we go. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you and a future. And so, friends, may you know Jesus as your hope and your future today. Amen. Amen.